So I'm literally sitting under the shade of our one Motherland okra. Baker Crete was really, really great. Our first packages did not yield any results, and so except for this one plant. This is the only thing that came from 20 seeds. And then we got our second round, and so we'll see what happens. But I'm a little sad, but this one is just so glorious. I just want this all around me. It's just beautiful, and I have not tried one of these pods yet, because it's really just getting into its stage where it's setting fruit really good. But as I was sitting here, I noticed something that I somehow missed. Must have been months ago, maybe because of where it's at. Let me just switch you around so you can see what I'm talking about. So here we have a pod that is dry. And the seeds are, you can see that. Okay, so what I was saying, going back, I'll probably edit all that out. What we have here is a okra pod that set a while ago, evidently, because it's already dried out. And the seeds, you can hear them in there, and right in there you can actually see them. So I'm not exactly sure what it is about the genetics of this plant that has made it difficult to germinate here in our soil, but this plant here obviously had no problem. So I thought the genetics of these seeds may be very, very, very well inclined to grow in our land. So I'm gonna harvest this, and instead of planting the seeds that Baker Creek sent back to me, I'm gonna soak these for 24 hours and plant these and see if our second round is a little bit better. So this will be an interesting journey. It is August the 9th, I believe, today. So we've got a little bit of time. I may need to actually plant these in the high tunnel just to be on the safe side and to be able to get a good yield from them before it's like cold, cold. Because the one thing I have learned about this Motherland okra is it does love it hot, because all of this fruit here, it just really starts setting over the last month. Like it's like, hey, eat, I love it. So yeah, I will plant these in the high tunnel instead of out here to ensure the best chances of success. I may plant one or two out here just to see and to possibly get more seed for next season. But stay tuned and we'll keep you updated on that journey. Okay, real quick, I clipped, I don't know what I was thinking. I clipped fruit from here and another area right along here already. And I squeezed them. I'm like, these jokers are too hard. I can't do anything with those. So looks like the way it sets fruit is just straight up like that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave these guys, these lower ones here. Let me see. That one's that top one. That one there is kind of soft. So these two here, this one, that one there, and this one I'm gonna harvest. But these other four I'm gonna leave for seed as well. Okay, now we have our seed, and to break into it, it's easier, of course, with one hand, but since I'm recording, I mean, it's easier with two hands, excuse me. Definitely easier with two hands. So I'm just gonna basically peel it open. I'm gonna try not to disturb them as much as, I already did it. Okay. Okay, so we are done. Looks like a little hand, alien hand. And we have a total of 61 seeds from that one pod. That's crazy. And I'm very excited about that. I hope that since these grew in our soil here, that the genetics that they save, that they carry, is gonna be more likely to produce more large healthy plants like the one these came from. So yeah, I am not going to be planting all of these for this year, for the fall, but I am going to be planting a good bit of them, probably about soaking about half of them for planting tomorrow. So I want to plant them in the morning, so I may need to wait until tomorrow morning to soak them to plant for Friday morning, because the instructions for the original seed packet are 24 hours soak. So that's what I'll do. I'll put these aside, and then tomorrow morning I'll start these, about half of them, in a soak, and then we will get them planted in the high tunnel. Okay, so morning definitely got away from me, and it is now evening. So our seeds soaked more like 36 hours than 24. Hope that's gonna be okay. It should. So on this row, on the right side here, I've just dug a slight trench, and you can see an okra plant right there. I'm gonna go to that plant and see how well we do with our spacing. I'm going to do about 4 to 6 inches, and I'm only doing that close just because the germination on these has not been great up to this point, but we'll see. Hoping that it's better with this go round, but at the same time, I don't have a lot of space to waste if it's not. So I'm going to put them about 4 to 6 inches a piece, and then I'm just going to cover them back up in this trench, and then we wait and see. Thanks for watching, guys. I will bring you back once we sprout.